In today's video, I will show you how to create 3D game NFT art, which is super popular. And I will be focusing on this pixelized 3D, which is actually created by Voxels. So if you're ready, let's go for it. Hello everyone, it's Petko Aleksandrov and I hope you are doing well. For the purpose of today's video, I'll be focusing on the VoxEdit, which is a free tool that we have on the Sandbox game. Just like with the Game Maker, with the VoxEdit, we can create 3D NFTs like avatars, wearables, all the stuff that they have on their marketplace. And if you are a creator, you can actually profit by selling your NFTs on the marketplace, and you can see that some of those worth a lot of money. Now, before I jump into the VoxEdit, I want to show you that they have a creators fund for $2 million. It is still open and you can apply if you are an artist. At fund.sandbox.game you can read the rules and what you need if you want to participate. But the main point is that you will get paid if you create NFTs, and if you create 3D game NFTs, and at the same time you will get 100% from the profits when you sell your art. And the other great thing is that you retain all rights and ownership of your content. But you can visit the page to learn more about it. Now, in order to get the VoxEdit, make sure you click on create, click on the VoxEdit and download it. Once you install it, it will open in a new window on your computer. And we have the news, the modeler, which I will talk about shortly, the animator. Then we have the block template and tutorials. Now, the tutorials are very, very useful. I'm not promoting the Sandbox game with this video, nor their channel, but they're very active on YouTube and their tutorials are really useful. So if you want to learn more about it, I strongly suggest you to go over them. But going back to the modeler, I would like to show you how you can start from scratch to create any type of 3D game art with the VoxEdit. So I will give it a name. For example, I will call it Cube 1. I don't know why I named it like that, but it's just because it's voxel art and those are small cubes. So this is what the VoxEdit looks like. If I click the left mouse, I will drop one voxel, okay? This small cube is called voxel. And if I press the left mouse, you will see that I will start dropping those voxels on my working spot. If I hold it and keep moving my mouse, I will keep creating shapes, right? And with the right mouse, I can rotate and see what I have created. Obviously, this is nothing. I'm just demonstrating for the video, but you can create really anything from scratch. Now, the size that we have by default is 32 by 32 by 32, and you can change it to anything you wish. For example, you can decrease the width to 10, and you can see that I have much smaller width. And pretty much on the top, we have different functions. On the left, we have the mode where we can select, paint or erase anything that you think you didn't want to do, and you can just delete it, right? And then we have a few more tools. On the right side, we have the palette, but let me show you some of the things I have done. For example, I have one virtual room that I'm planning to build on my virtual land and sandbox. I'm planning to replicate there my house with the YouTube studio, with my yellow chair and trading desk, microphone, everything. So this is like a small project that I have started for the kitchen, and I can change everything here as colors, or if I don't like anything, I can erase it, or I can move it with the selection tool if I decide to move For example, this shelf, I can move it higher or lower. I can do really a lot and change everything that I don't like. But about this project, probably I will talk in another video. Now with the animator, we have different options to change the head of the avatar, the arms, the weapons, if you will. We have templates which are super useful. For example, there are some animals, avatars with a horse or mammal actually. And if I select it, for example, I will need to write a name. Okay, YouTube video test 2. And I will click on save. And you see that these are all editable, right? I can make changes. And on the left side, we have the skeleton, which is in a separate folder. And it's all put together. And if I hit the play button, you'll see that it's actually moving and rotating. And it's really cool because it is a ready thing. I don't need to start from scratch and build all of that. It is ready. And for example, if I want to change something with the head, right? If I double click, I see where it is in the skeleton. And if I hit the pencil, you will see how it opens. And then I can change anything I wish. For example, I can make the eyes bluish, right? I can select a color and I can make blue eyes. Actually, this way I added a voxel in front of the head. Or if I press Ctrl Z and I want to change just the colors, I can hit on the paint mode, and if I select the voxel I want to change, you see that I changed just the color of the eyes, right? One more time, if I want to put a cube or a voxel in front of it to make it more 3D or to change the shape in some way, I can do that. As well, if I want to put some nose for the avatar, I can do that as well. For example, I can give it such a shape. Or if I wanna put the voxels in front of the mount, just to make the head a little bit more 3D. If you will, for example, I can drop some voxels on the top. As well, the ears, change the colors, or to make any type of change, you can do that, right? Let me do the same for the other one. Here it is. Okay, did I do it the same way? Yep, I think it's pretty similar. So now if I just go back, it will ask me to save my changes. I will hit on yes, and you can see that the changes are in there. The eyes are blue, as well are the ears, the nose, the mouth. Okay, some changes that I did really quickly, just to show you that if I play the button, play again, it is all put together, it is acting together, and this is pretty cool. Same thing I can do with the body, with the chest, or with the arms, the legs. You can see that they are all different elements, and if I double click on those, I can edit them in the skeleton. And from there I can export in different formats, or I can export it straight to the marketplace, which is super useful if you are an artist on the Sandbox game. All right, if you are not, if you just want to play around it, and if you want to practice modeling, this is one of the best tools out there because it is super easy to use, it is free. You can start from scratch and you can experiment building your own avatars or your own head, if you will, anything that you wish, just to see how that works. It is a great tool to create 3D NFTs. And the VoxEdit is linked to the marketplace of Sandbox, which, as you know, is one of the biggest by trading volume. On the left side, we have so many different options. We have the lens as well, the different equipment, the wearables that are available, or you can select on all to see all NFTs that are for sale currently on the marketplace. And if I visit the OpenSea website quickly and I go to rankings, you will see that Sandbox is always somewhere on the top. All right, currently it dropped to number 18, but still the volume is huge, okay? 2,700 Ethereum by the time of recording this video. Currently, we are in a very bearish market. The Russian-Ukrainian crisis and the trading volume is low with the cryptos, the NFTs. The whole market is quite negative currently, which is super understandable. However, there is still a huge volume traded in the Sandbox game. And I think personally this is because of the great tools they have offered, like the VoxEdit, where we can create 3D game art and creators have the possibility to sell them on the marketplace, which is a great way to earn profits nowadays, right? So you can see how different arts those are, and all are voxels, which gives a pixelized illusion. And obviously the pixelized art ever since CryptoPunks is super popular and keeps value. All right, guys, let me know if you have any questions. Check out the complete metaverse course that I have recorded, and I have used Sandbox as an example in the description below. I will drop it with a coupon for all of my subscribers. If you have any questions, let me know, and I'll be glad to see your experience with the VoxEdit and Sandbox in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and don't leave without hitting the like button. Have a wonderful day. Cheers.